Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our Unite Gathering, and this is our first Unite Gathering na ni fall on a Saturday because we usually hold it every Thursday. And to cater to the students na medyo grabe ka stressful and hectic ang activities sa weekdays, so we plan to hold another Unite Gathering on a Saturday. So starting this week, twice na ang Unite Gatherings, but same ra ang ato ang lesson, the series that we're going through is just the same. Okay, so by the way, I think everyone, for formality's sake, I'm Faith Ann Rañises. You can call me Ate Faith. Siguro wala na ani mga names diri nga mga calls ako tita. Dili na pwede mag tita. So last week, Pastor Al was this like shared to us about the inner life, and kaganina na enumerate na pud ni Atalani, no, but I'll just share it with you guys. So the inner life comprises of five dimensions. First is the inner compulsions, gives us the impetus for life, atong mga impulses, and the inner convictions, what holds on to us, what sticks to us. Next is our inner conscience, what is right and wrong. Our inner compass, our direction and orientation, and our inner composure, the steadiness of our soul. And that is important for us to remember or to define each of these five dimensions, because Pastor Edmund Chan said, we cannot develop what we cannot define. So that's why last week we defined Gidnato siya. And we're going through a series entitled Cultivating Our Inner Life. And muna siya na book for those who want to purchase a copy or buy this book. Okay. That's been a blessing to me, good kayo, personally. And for those who did not join us last week, this is the message. Yeah. You can check it out on INSIDEOUTGCAF on our Facebook page. Okay, so balik ta sa inner life. The inner life is very important, and how can we cultivate our inner life? By studying, reading, and doing God's work. It's in Psalm 119, verse 105, it says, your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. So, mo na siya karon. But did you know na there is such thing as toxic spirituality? And kaninga word ba nga toxic? In 2018, Oxford Dictionary declared toxic as the word of the year. More than ever, people have been using this term, the term toxic, not only on things, but even on events and people. But recently lang nato siya gaka-coin nga term, uy, toxic na siya nga tao, or like, oh, grabe ka toxic sa work, toxic ang school, toxic ang parents, yung ano. But even before 2018, nga lagi na siya ang term, di ba? But karun lang yun siya na popularize. And even before that declaration sa 2018, Pastor Edmund Chan already tells us that there is such thing as toxic spirituality because he wrote the book early 2000. And yeah. So toxic spirituality results to toxic Christianity, and what is on the inside shows on the outside, and that can be very dangerous. I also shared this to my wider group, but everything we do is also spiritual. It is a reflection of our inner life. And that is why it can be very dangerous if you have toxic spirituality, because we might be the reason why people are allergic to Christians or allergic to Christianity, and we might misrepresent God. This can be caused by wrong mindset as well. When we thought that we're cultivating our inner life, but then in the end, we were wrong. So let's all together discover the five features of toxic spirituality. But I humbly ask you that we don't use this learning to judge other people, to point fingers to other people. But first and foremost, let us evaluate ourselves, our personal inner life. So the five features of toxic spirituality. The first one is service without joy. The Bible says in Psalm 100 verse 2, serve the Lord with gladness. I believe all of us, we all start serving God joyfully. Yet in the long run, we get discouraged. We get tired and we feel used and abused. This causes us to feel serving as a chore. And wala na kita'y gana. Baka wala siya'y gana. And maybe you might even think of changing church, transferring church, or stop going church. Why? Because people are very hard to serve. And not only, yeah, people, both the leaders and the members of the of your asakaga serve. And through Judna, because we have different personalities and niligin maiwasan niya, there will be clash of ideas, clash of personalities at times. And that is why it's so easy but to share, oh Lord, I love you, I want to serve you, Lord, but it's very hard to serve other people. We can even say, Lord, I love the world, I pray for world peace. Pero dili ka at peace sa imong neighbor. Kakasapot ka sa imong neighbor, kay insensitive ka ayo. But is that really the reason that we have service without joy? The true reason, the real reason why we experience service without joy is the lack of our inner composure, and we allow compulsions to take over. And that is mostly what takes over is our pride. And we need to see as God sees. How does God see people? With compassion. And there's this verse in Matthew 14:14. It says, when he, that's Jesus, when he went ashore, he saw a large crowd and felt compassion for them and healed their sick. And naabot gud, naabtan gud sila o kanang late gabi na no, na because of this verse, the following verses after this was the feeding of the 5,000. The disciples told Jesus, nga, Jesus, ipaulit na sila, kay, they already received healing bitaw. So, ipaulit na sila. But Jesus said, na, give them food to eat. So, that is true compassion. Second is performance without rest. And performance without rest is beyond the physical rest. It is the restedness of the spirit, of our spirit. Because ministry is an outflow of our life. So the more we grow in the Lord, the more we can give. The more we respond to God's call to serve other people, to get involved in a ministry. And insecurity is one cause of restlessness because we are focusing on what other people will say. So if ever we have this commitment sa ministry, makauna tayo, hala, chada ka ang ilang nakita sa ako, okay baka to ako ang performance ila, but diba we are called to serve with the audience of one, no mat bala na unsay ingnon sa ubang tao. And I've also learned from the book, no, na it is also good to give the best that we can offer at the certain time. So this is called giving our optimum best. So how can we give our optimum best so that we will be rested through it all, through the busyness of the ministry involvement? First is you recognize your gift. So what is the gift, the skill, or the talent that God has given you? And number two, recognize that it's God leading you to do it. And third, don't be caught in the performance act, the performance trap, I mean. Performance trap meaning conscious kay ka sa exterior factors, what other people will say. So example, ani, for sa mga students, no? Sa mga students, you have, saba, Monday to Friday, you have online class. And karun kay busy kayo with mga requirements sa school, nga halos tanan, mura video editing na, no? So example, you have a project with a deadline and it's kanang drama. Yeah, group pagyud mo. In order to beat that deadline, there are some things that you cannot do. Example, karun gihatag and then due siya next Wednesday. So there are a lot of things na you want to do pero kulang sa time and dili pagyud mo pwede mag-meeting with your group physically, di ba? So na yung mga limitations. But that's the best that you can do at the certain time frame given and with the circumstances, diba? So God honors that, and kanang, yeah, God honors that, and God kanang granted you grace, but to perform, despite of. So dili gid ta mag-wait until we can give our 100% to say man, diba? Usually, naagin yung mga company ng mga presentations, Christmas presentations. So, let's say, naamoy Christmas caroling contest. So, on top of work, on the side, mag-conceptualize ka and magsabot mo sa inyong groupmates mag-practice. Of course, pag humani yung present, yung makating ka, dapat unta, naging anim ni, naging ana, wala, feeling ni mo na ay kulang. But, you gave your best without neglecting your other responsibilities. And God honors that. And that is what we call doing our optimum best. So, we can do our optimum best in order to perform and at the same time be rested with God. And because the best expression of excellence is obedience and faithfulness. So, the real question is, did you obey God and were you faithful with the time, talent, and treasure that God has entrusted you? Third is work without worship. Related kini siya sa performance without rest because our work and the ministry that is entrusted to us can be our source of security or passes nato makaingon ta nga, okay na Lord, nag-serve, naka-serve man ko kaganina. So, dili na ko kailangan mag-quiet time kay kapuy kaayo or sa Sunday, naka-teach ka sa kids whole day and you don't make time for your personal worship. Or you say, I already gave to the poor man. So, okay na nga, dili na ako mag-church karong Sunday. I already did a good deed. So, that's actually wrong because we're too busy for the kingdom but we don't have time for the king. In reality, God does not need us, but He hopes that if He tags us along with the work, we grow closer to Him. Same maghapon na siya sa naganina, no? To work for God is an outflow of our grateful worship of God. And in our spiritual journey, it is worship that defines our work. Yes, so, yeah. Muna siya, and at times, grabe, for me po, kay ako ang guilty gud kay ko ani kay ang ako ang mind kay sige go work before matulog ba. Say buhaton ugma, first kani, then kani, anana. Pagkauman kay makatulog na lang dayon, dili na mag end sa day with a prayer. But so it is also toxic po nga spirituality for me. So how can I correct it? So being rested in God means to be faithful with God and trust with what God has entrusted with me today and laying tomorrow in His hands. And that is a form of worship. It says in Psalm 4 verse 8, "In peace I will lie down and sleep, for you alone, Lord, make me dwell in safety." So worship is very important. Fourth is devotion without discipleship. True devotion is expressed in discipleship to God. Otherwise, it is just merely feeling without doing. Murag tama na siya sa ba-ba, lip service without the life to show it. So what does discipleship to Christ mean? Who is a disciple of Christ? A disciple of Christ is one who commits to follow Jesus, who's changed by Jesus and who makes disciples for Jesus. So di niya siya pwede pilian lang. This is kani gid tulo. It can be said that discipleship without devotion is blind and devotion without discipleship is lame. So devotion and discipleship must always come together. And a Christian devotion is tied to biblical discipleship. And this biblical discipleship is tied to spiritual disciplines. So question, how are you cultivating your inner life by spiritual disciplines? What are examples of spiritual disciplines? How about your quiet time? Do you do your quiet time? Do you join church, even virtual gatherings? Do you still give your tithe? Do you continue to join your wider group? Especially karun nga pandemic, no? It's really a test of spiritual discipleship. Sa yun nabi ingon nga lisod mag-meet, kay hina ang signal, walay pang data and all. But I'm not saying no nga, it's not a valid reason. Kay tinod mag-meet na siya. But there's a saying that goes, kung gusto, gawan ng paraan, pero pag ayaw, maraming dahilan. So it's always a matter of our heart. So let's check in our hearts. That's why I'm thankful to you guys, no, na despite of the rain, medyo fluctuating ba ang signal kung mag-ulan, and despite of the cool breeze, hangin karon na maglamit na kay sayo-sayo itulog, you chose to be here, to join, to grow your relationship with God, to learn together. So ako personally, I struggle with this during the pandemic ba. Mayo kay ko sa sugod, exercise and then quiet time. So grabe siya nga, spiritual discipline for me. Wala gin ako na miss, pero pagka kadugayan kay nakapoy na or ganang feeling nga, dili bitaw ko pangutan-on kung naka-quiet time ba ko or wala. Wala bitaw ko'y ma-meet na people who will check on me. But I realized to nga, it was a wrong mindset na I have to do it for myself and I need to start meeting wider groups for accountability para naay makahelp sa ako ang upadayon gid akong spiritual growth. And I'm blessed now with some wider group members na they really make time, Jude. And murag to a point na sila ngayon nga pwede mag-call na lang ta kay wala sila pang data. So yeah, some of our wider groups, we meet conference call, and the others we also meet video call, you know. So it says in Devotion Without Discipleship by Thomas Merton said, there are no shortcuts in the spiritual life. Those who imagine that they can discover spiritual gimmicks and work for them usually ignore God's will and grace. There are neither shortcuts nor gimmicks. It is devotion and discipleship. Devotion and discipleship come together. And that is why we do not have spiritual growth. Because while we have the desire, we don't have the discipline. So, discipline is the key. And lastly, the fifth, ritual without reality. So, what are some rituals we do personally for our inner life? Quiet time can be a ritual. Prayer. Or even kanang mag-post o Bible verse sa ato ang Facebook profile, Facebook page, or sa story. But the question is it a reality to us? Or maybe we're too focused ba on checking it off on our to-do list. But wala giday siya naging reality sa ato ano. And that can be a ritual without reality. And tendency magid ani is we focus on outward form and we merely go through the motions. So for me, no, sa akong quiet time, how do I check myself kung ritual, if it is ritual without reality? By the end of the day, i-check akong self if na-remember ba na ako unsa akong na-learn sa akong quiet time early this morning. Okay, if nalimtan ako, meaning I didn't take it to heart, I didn't try to apply it within the day, and yeah, it was purely just ritual without reality. So, motor shine, even kanang prayer before meals pud na ako, I check that, no, na nahimo ra ba siya ritual nga balik-balik ra ba akong prayer, and ginadali ba nako kung gutomon ko or dali ba nako siya gakalimtan. So muna siya ang ako-apong how I check my spiritual life. because rituals, no matter how beautiful or good, it can become empty for a while. So that is the danger of ritual without reality. So these are the five descriptions, no, of toxic spirituality: service without joy, performance without rest, work without worship, devotion without discipleship, and ritual without reality. So that's toxic spirituality. And we need to define this in order for us to develop and move from toxic spirituality to having true spirituality, because it is truly our prayer and our desire that each one of us, the youth of today, will truly live from the inside out. So karun, yes, we still have time. I have guide questions here for us to reflect and to share sa small group, no? Sa base sa unsa to na learn tonight.